Hi everyone, welcome to August 2017. Wanted to pop in here real quick and do just a little bit of a hello. Let you guys know that as of now, private readings are back to normal. Thank you so much to all of those that ordered a private reading and put up with my nonsense. I had just a whole bunch of stuff happen right before I left Indonesia, which was like so typical of the whole experience there. Dealing with immigration, they held my passport hostage for like a month, and it was like the day before I had to go when I finally got it. So I spent like 3 days waiting, systems down in Jakarta and all this, like, I don't know, it was just like a total mess. But so thank you for those that put up with me, and yeah, so it'll be back to normal. Also, quick announcement for freebies for Leo, okay? Every month, whoever's birthday month it is, I will be offering free solar return reports. So if you order a tarot card reading, I'll include, it's like a 20-page report that talks about the themes for the upcoming year based on your birthday and your residence location, okay? So it's kind of like a snapshot analysis of things that you can expect with your specific transits and things like that. It's kind of a cool report. I ran one for myself for being here in Budapest on my upcoming birthday in September. And I don't know, it's kind of cool to look at. So that's available for you as well. I'm gonna be doing a Bali video, another one. I know I already did one regarding the astrocartography, and I'm gonna do another one now that I know a little bit more about it. I'm kind of analyzing what happened when I was there and kind of associating it with transit, things like that. And also being here in Budapest and how it really is going to be affecting my chart. And like I said, I am offering astrocartography analysis in a more simple form for some of you who are interested in vacationing or moving to a new city and whatnot, just so that you can kind of get an idea of how the planets will shift and the possibility of having different aspects of your personality kind of be activated based on where your planets are located. So it's kind of a cool thing. And I will be doing that probably in the next month, as well as my new astrological video for Venus. I did one on Chiron already, and I have a whole new format that I'm gonna do for Venus, which I'm pretty excited about, because the first one was kind of just like haphazard, just kind of threw it together, but to hopefully make it more valuable for you so that you can understand how your Venus affects the way you love and interact with people and the way that you appreciate beauty and life in general. So keep your eyes open for that, and that's it. I'll let you guys go. Thanks so much. Bye. Hello, Pisces. How are you? Welcome to your August reading. Can you guys believe we're in August already? I can't even believe it. This year has been such a crazy year for me, anyway. let's go ahead and get started. Excuse me, I have something in my throat. Oh, that's weird. I pulled this card out first for Aquarius as well. I know the eclipse is happening in Aquarius, so one of the eclipses. So I'll start out the same way with you as I started out with them. How are you feeling? What are you thinking? How are things going? What's going on in your mind? What's going on in your heart? There's obviously a lot of confusion, a significant lack of clarity. Okay. A lot of choices. It seems like you kind of have like an infinite number of choices in front of you, and you just really don't quite know what. You don't know what. You don't know why. You don't know what the outcome is. You don't know if you choose this one, is it going to have a good outcome? And if you choose that one, is it going to have a good outcome? Sorry, I don't know what's going on with my voice right now. I don't know what's going on. There we go. It's back to normal now. Had like something in there. The thing about this one, okay, is it's like we put so much pressure on ourselves to pick the right choice, but there's really not right choices. You know, there's only choices and the consequences that follow. So to pick the one with the most favorable consequences is really kind of your best route, you know, to really think about it like that. Obviously, there's something going on in your mind, okay? A lot of things going on in your mind. You're really in a period of restraint, holding yourself back, pushing yourself to stay, pushing yourself to be in the same place. You know, there's probably a lot of questions about just all aspects of life based on this one decision. If I make this one decision, how is this going to impact every other area of my life? How is it going to impact my family, my children, my home, my finances, my career, my everything? The thing you have to remember about the swords are illusions. Okay, they're projections. They're things that you create. So these fears and these doubts are all things that are things that you are creating in your own mind. Okay? And your stagnation and your hesitation is as much of a choice as making a different choice. Okay? So, like I said, I think I said this in Aquarius too, inaction is as much of an action as an action. Okay? So, you have to remember that. Likely you haven't been receiving the things that you wanted, right? Or you haven't been communicating, you haven't heard from someone, you haven't heard from that person, you haven't received the kind words or the apology or whatever it was that you were hoping for, whatever it is you felt that you needed isn't coming in. And a lot of times we stay in this place because we're like waiting for that thing to come in. We're waiting for that moment or to hear from that person or waiting to hear news of something. But you can't sit around and wait forever, you know, because the universe doesn't work like that. You are an entity that is existing in a system that is cycles upon cycles upon cycles upon cycles, from the microscopic scale to the universal scale. Nothing is ever holding still, ever. The planets are always moving. And so your hesitation and that clinging because you're not hearing from someone or you're not getting what you are needing or think that you're needing, is futile. Those efforts are wasted efforts because you're gonna be forced to change anyway at some point. Now, the fact of the matter is, Pisces, is that you have received some form of enlightenment about something. You've become clear about something, and now you're like, okay, well, now I have this information and now I understand this. And now I can see the real deal. I can see the real person. I can see the real version of myself. You know, whatever it is, I can see it. But just because you've received that information, just because you've received that clarity, it's up to you to act. It's up to you to accept or deny. Right now, there's neither acceptance nor denial. It's just you've got the information, but it's like you haven't, like you received the envelope, but you haven't opened the envelope to hear, to see what it is yet. Or you saw what it was and you didn't like it. So when you are faced with this, and you are needing to make a judgment, because this isn't just judgment upon you, this is judgment in your own life, your own judgment. So when you are faced with a moment of judgment, you can make a choice to stay, to go to the right or go to the left, or up or down or inside or out or wherever. And you have to remember the consequences. What are the consequences of each choice? Because it's likely that you already know. You already know that if you go left, this is likely to happen. If you go right, this is likely to happen. Some of you are facing a break with the past. Okay, some of you are facing a disconnection, a breakup, some of you. Some of you are disconnecting from or rejecting news from someone. Some of you may be hearing from someone and you saying, okay, well, that's not for me. That's not what I want. I've already moved past it. Some of you may be removing or detaching yourself from something that you obviously created something with, right? We have the flowers, so you've created something there, but now it's lost its purpose. So the Strength card is about maintaining and managing that physical world, right? You have the woman who represents the divine feminine connected with the ether. Okay, we have the immortality of her soul and the controlling, closing the mouth of the lion. Closing the mouth, taming the beast being your reality, okay? And, or what you perceive to be your reality. And that does take strength, and it does, you are being held accountable. You are responsible for that. You can live a life of, you know, going and coming and you know, just like floating around. You can do that. But when you do that, I think your life is less, you know, you're more likely to hit a lot of brick walls, you know, rather than choosing choices that have favorable consequences. Five of Pentacles reversed. You're not in the best place. Your physical world is not in the best place. Now, this doesn't have anything to do with like general comforts of life and the things that you can be grateful for, right? It doesn't mean that you're starving. It doesn't mean you're homeless. It doesn't mean that you aren't, you know, don't have a good family life or a good support system or anything like that. But it's just that there's something dissatisfactory. You know, just because your basic needs are met doesn't mean, you know, maybe you even have excess. Maybe you even have extra money. But at the end of the day, the material aspects of life are not necessarily those things that motivate and drive us, you know, from a spiritual standpoint. And so there is some dissatisfaction there. You may need to be rejecting someone, or someone may be rejecting you in light of this, in light of this moment. Like, okay, I finally understand. I've reached that aha moment. I get it. And now I need to make this judgment. Judgment whether this is for me or this is not for me, whether I'm going to walk into the light or if I'm going to walk into the darkness, because the darkness is resistance. You know, what you resist, what's the saying? I think it's whatever you resist persists. So you can walk into a world of resistance and resist the information and the truth. It's going to put you into cards like the Devil, the Tower, Death, the Moon. Okay, these darker, more difficult energies. It's more frustrating energies. Or you can walk into the light. You can walk into the Star and the Sun and the Hanged Man, which is actually a really beautiful card representing and indicating wisdom. Okay, it's kind of connected with the High Priestess, with the Kabbalah Tree of Life. So you have options. You know the right one, and it's up to you to walk in that direction. See the Sun reversed. It's your environment. The Star is reversed here with the Pentacles. You're kind of rejecting the sunlight. It's like you're afraid. You're afraid of the change, even though the change is for the better. Yes, feeling lost, okay. You're not really lost though, you know? You're not. You're being very guided. You're being very directed. I mean, this is a very like clear, here's the right path, take it or leave it. Why is it then when you're receiving messages that are so clear that you can still be not you, Pisces, just everybody, you, everyone in general. Why is it then we receive messages that are so clear and so damning that yet we still are like, I don't know what to do? Why do we do that to ourselves? You know what to do. We all know what to do. You can live in your current state of a Five of Pentacles, or you can head in the direction of the Ten of Pentacles and actually have the things you want. That's an option. Having the things you want is actually an option, guys. The universe wouldn't give you this if it didn't want to see you here. Family, comfort, networks, happiness, joy. Okay? There does seem to be a lacking of happy emotions, though. I think those happy emotions will come once the break has occurred. Once you're taking control over this feeling of isolation. Okay? And to really say to yours, you know, I wish I could find this quote again. I don't remember where I saw it. I think I saw it on Instagram or something, but I'm not even going to say it right. I'll probably butcher it. But it was like, the more and more you try to change, the least likely you are to change. It's when you accept yourself as perfect, as a perfect person, exactly the way you are, is when change begins to happen. And I think that's what kind of needs to happen, is you're pushing yourself so hard to change who you are on the inside instead of acknowledging that you are a perfect version of what you are supposed to be, which is a person living in this seemingly physical reality. And your job in this reality is to make choices and to learn from those choices and to do what feels good and to not do what feels bad. And to not resist what the universe is calling upon you to do, because it's not going to give you a direction to go unless there's a reason for that direction. And this direction could be good or bad, but it's like, what are you going to do with that choice? It's the universe's job to give you directions, to give you pathways, and it's your job to choose which one. But I feel that you are, again, there's a lot of resistance there. Guys, the more you fight it, the more you hang on to it, the more you try to keep something or someone, the more you fight for something, it's like the more and more it slips through your fingers. And you're the only one fighting anyway. You're the only one fighting for it. You're the only one that wants it this bad. I feel like someone's not on your side. Like you're really operating on two different pages. It's like two different books in two different libraries in two different continents. Like it's totally, you're not like there with this person or with this situation. But you're totally deserving and you're totally on track to have that same page, same library, same continent, same book with someone if you take this information and do what you need to do with it. I'm not saying some of you are going to be breaking up for sure. It can be with the same person. It's just getting you guys back going in the same direction. And here's that tower. I mean, you've already experienced that. These kind of go hand in hand, the tower and judgment. All right, they do go hand in hand. And it's almost as though by not getting that thing that you want is kind of what was the straw that broke the camel's back. Right? So you don't get what you want. You don't hear what you want. That person doesn't say what you need them to say at the moment that you need them to say it. And so it sends you in a little bit of a spiral, and in that moment, the universe is like, here, you've seen everything you need to see, you've heard everything you need to hear, and here's your way out. There's no stability there, absolutely not. Some of you may even be literally uprooting something, you know, moving away from home, moving away from what's comfortable, changing locations. You know, you are ripping up the tree from the roots, essentially, is kind of what this Four of Wands reverse speaks to. And that's what this information was about, was a really significant change. Okay. I mean, I feel like if you continue to go down this path where you're at, now I know some of you might be single. I'm not watching, you know, I don't know if right now is really the best time to invite new love into your life. Okay, I think there's energy that must still be kind of tidied up and buttoned up and cleaned up and really accepted and understood before new love can feel the way it's supposed to feel, you know, where it gives you that sense of security and it gives you that sense of safety and fun and joy. Because right now you're a little bit too ungrounded because of the Four of Wands reversed. And I think, again, you're still kind of fighting your own limitations a little bit. And you're really seeing those limitations for what they are. And your own limitations in terms of your ability to manifest, right? Because if you can say to the universe and try to manifest the perfect relationship with this person all you want. But if the universe is like, no, you have a different purpose. You have a different path. But you're still so much about this. Well, it's just going to give you more of this and more of the sun reversed and, you know, more of not getting what you want. It's kind of like, you know, the new age movement, I guess, wants you to sit there and meditate and be like, I'm in a loving relationship. My partner is great. I love this person. They love me. And, you know, it wants you to think positive about something, right? But that's not exactly what manifestation really is. You know, it needs to be more open-ended and invite limitless possibilities with the possibility that your current state might not be the best possibility. You know? Because no matter what, the universe is going to smack you on track. And this can be really hard once you get to that point. And the universe is like, no, stop. Stop trying to like do everything that I'm trying to get you not to do, and it's going to force you eventually down a specific path. And some of you are really, really, really hitting that wall of your own limitations by resisting so much, by resisting change and progress. And here we have someone, something. I don't know what this is. An air sign, Sagittarius. But also Leo or Aries, okay? But you have to be careful with the Knight of Wands, especially in a love reading. It can be someone that could be very hurtful and very selfish, okay? Someone that enjoys fun, enjoys adventure. They can be loyal and they can be really good friends, but they're not the most stable. And Pisces, you being someone that really needs emotional security, I do feel that this person, whoever this is, whether it's your current partner, right? Like maybe it's the person that needs to be tamed, if you will, or like where you, it's like the beast in your life that needs to be addressed kind of thing. The one that's really testing your patience. Okay. You know, they really are. They are testing your patience. And they do pull you back. See, it's in the backward motion. They do pull you back. They draw you in. They suck you into the past and they kind of keep you in this circle. And here we have the moon, card of Pisces. And what did I say? You avoid you can either head from judgment, you can either head into the darkness, which is the tower, the devil, death, and the moon, Or you can head into the light, which is the star, the sun, and you know, the hanged man, and seeing things for what they really are, and different perspectives and higher levels of understanding, you know. And right now you're in that darkness realm because I do think that you're resisting what you've been shown. You're resisting it, and you're trying to keep things contained. There's a need for you to break free a little bit, a need for you to do your Pisces swimming thing and go and try to find that. The word that's coming to my mind is freedom. And I said the same thing to Aquarius as well. Like, there's a need for liberty. There's a need for you to have space. You're in a very unknown place right now, but I think it's a little bit of your own undoing. It's a little bit of your own undoing. When I say your own undoing, is because you are the 12th house ruler, the house of undoing, okay? Meaning everything that you kind of built, you've kind of gone past that part of beauty and amazingness, and you've kind of circled back. I feel like it was taken too far. Something got taken too far. And it took you too far down this road in spite of warning signs along the way. And now you're like, the universe is kind of maybe like, they gave you one last sign, one last, like one of those big green signs on the interstate that says, this is your last sign. This is where you need to go. But it was ignored. And now you're like, okay, I only have the guidance of the moon. The moon can be beautiful because the universe will never abandon you. It's always there. It's always watching out for you. But, you know, you did kind of choose this path. You did kind of, you know, cause a lot of this as well. I'm not blaming you guys, but, you know, we all have to take responsibility for our own life, you know, and allowing people to take advantage of us and allowing people to steal from us, to steal our love and to steal our time, steal our energy and whatever it is, you know, like, you are responsible for that as well. Like, you as well, and I say that to every sign, you know, it's not just you. 10 of Wands reversed. Look, you're so tired. How can you not be tired when you've been the only one fighting? There's a lot of like anxiety between, you know, what it is you're doing and your thoughts, and your thoughts are obviously going crazy. Your heart's going crazy. 7 of Cups. So your heart, your mind, and your actions, they're all like going, it's like actually being torn in like 3 different directions. It's not even like you have 2 that are on the same page. It's like there's so much. I wouldn't say confusion. There's just a lot of inconsistencies and a lot of lack of alignment. The thing with Pisces is you're so chill on the outside. You know, it's like people don't even know. You're so nice and so kind and so easygoing and all of this. But on the inside, it's like a whole different story. Whole different story. You're operating on a level that is so deep and so dramatic, you know, and it can be dangerous because you might not be letting it out appropriately. 3 of Pentacles is a promising sign of progress. Look, this is one to go down in the history books for you, whatever this year has been for you. Definitely one to go down in the history books as one of the biggest pivotal moments of your life. That's how it has been for everybody. 2017 has turned out to be really, really good in some areas and really, really tough in others. And take that as a blessing that you are able to evolve in the way that you have evolved and to learn things. I think a lot of us were forced to face our inner demons a lot. They were forced to face our darkest selves, our darkest shadow selves. Some of us may have even met our shadow twins. Some of us have even met our, I call them catch and release. This is my own thing. I totally just made it up. But like we have the twin flame, we have the soulmate, which we're all familiar with. And I am coining the new catch and release category, which is a karmic relationship. It is something that is meant to be, but it's meant to be only on the physical plane. It is meant to bring out, I'm sorry, bleh. It is meant to be only on the spiritual plane. I think I said physical, but only on the spiritual plane. It is meant to be a connection of souls for us to attain our highest level of love and to sort of tickle our soul so that we remember that we are in fact alive. But in the physical world, there are too many incompatibilities. Incompatibilities with religion, education, culture, habits, personality, all these things that will not work. It's usually a very short-lived relationship, and it's one of those where you come into each other's lives and you love each other as hard as you can, and then you let each other go. And I think more relationships are actually like that, but we want them to be these twin flames and these soulmates, and we try to force these connections because, you know, sometimes you, like you look back and you're like, you know, when I first met, this relationship was everything I ever wanted. It was amazing. The sex was so good. Our spirits were in tandem. Everything was so beautiful. I just fell so in love with this person. And then it just got so bad, you know, and it does. They do. They get so bad sometimes. Not all of them, right? Not everything is any one. Not everything is one category. And sometimes it's nothing, you know. But I think we encounter more of these catch and release people, energies into our lives, but we're like conditioned so much to think that we need to find the one. So we force these people who we know from the get-go are wrong, and our intuition says this isn't going to work out, but for some reason we just have this soul connection, you know, but we just try to resist the incompatibilities, and it causes a lot of drama in our life. Here we have a card of fun, okay? A card of celebration, a card of goodness, which tells me that there's likely to be a breaking free for you very soon. If not in August, then maybe September. There's going to be a breaking free. There's going to be a reason to feel happy and a reason to feel like you understand why you are where you are now. And the Four of Pentacles is that clinging. You know, you're clinging to this disaster of some kind. You're clinging to this broken foundation. But yet you're here, and there's this universe is like, go, move, stop. It's yelling at you. It's begging you to stop staying so comfortable. Now is a time for you to get uncomfortable and to head out and leave things behind. I'm not saying all of you are going to break up. That's not what I'm saying. It's whatever issue this mess has really caused, okay? There needs to be movement. And the universe can and will be very, very generous to you. But you gotta make space for it. If you're clinging to the four, your hands are not free to accept the six. Your hands must be open. You must be available. You must be willing to accept. See, and it's like you're projecting, I won't get that. It's never gonna work. I'm never gonna have this. I'm never gonna be blessed in this way. Okay, well then you won't. If you think that, then you won't. There is an element of humility around here. There's a need or a pull to be humble, to not let your pride get in the way. I think I said this for one of my private readings. I'm gonna repeat it to you now. A lot of times we misunderstand ourselves. And we think, okay, well, my intuition is saying I need to leave, but my heart, I love this person so much, and I can't, like, I've invested so much, I can't just walk away. That is not your heart, that is your pride. Your intuition in this particular scenario, I feel, is your heart and mind working together, but your ego is your true enemy in this scenario. Okay. This idea of, like, the one, you know, and if you believe in, like, twin flames, then you believe in past lifetimes. So if you believe in past lifetimes, you must believe in more lifetimes. And that takes the pressure off of trying to find the one in this lifetime. That's just like a physical desire that you have to satisfy physical needs. That's all that is. And if you truly believe that there is a twin flame out there, and you believe that maybe you are with that person, but it's not working out and it's making you feel sick, it's making you feel unhappy, it's stressing you out, it's keeping you up at night, you're crying, whatever. If that's the what it's doing to you, then you should feel free to let it go because you have faith that you will meet again. You know? We do put a lot of pressure on ourselves to find the one. I'm not saying that it doesn't exist, but I'm saying that the pressure for it to exist with the people that make us unhappy is very much, you know, I believe to be a more of a cultural conditioning than anything else. That's just my own thing. I'll probably get some pushback on that. But when you think about it, like, what is this need and this desire for us to find the one? I think that's a very modern concept. It's a very Hollywood concept. I don't think that was a concept like 150 years ago. I really don't. People got married for, like, property exchanges, you know? It wasn't for love. I don't know. I may be just interjecting my nonsense. But your intuition is speaking. Listen to it. It is the emergence, right? The emergence of your spiritual self that is connected to the ether, that is your gateway to the universe, right? And she is the keeper of truth, keeper of wisdom. She's got the Torah, and she's got the moon under her foot. See, here the moon is controlling you. Here you control the moon. You control the darkness. You control the confusion. So it is in your control. And the universe wants you to make this change. It wants you to leave. It wants you to get uncomfortable. I forgot to talk about that, but Four of Cups is, you know, I know you're trying to be cautious and you're trying to think things through and you're trying to be mature and you're trying to do the right thing and all of this. But again, here's a message for you to really let your guard down in terms of yourself, not necessarily with your interaction with other people, but with yourself, because you're guarding yourself against yourself. And she's like knocking at the door like, hello, is anybody home? Are you listening? Where are you? What's going on? Listen, please listen to me. And, you know, you got to make space for that. And really ask yourself how prideful you have been. How prideful you have been to cling and to hang on to an idea. Again, you're clinging to the four, but the universe wants to give you the six. It's like trying. It's like, here, I'm trying to give this to you. Don't you want it? And you're like, no, I'm happy with what I have. But what you have is this, you know? And then you have this person who is probably driving you crazy a little bit, annoys you, frustrates you. Doesn't have to be a person. It could be an issue, okay? It could be something that's nagging at you. It could even be a work thing, okay? I'm talking to relationship terms, but it's that thing that presence in your life that keeps you feeling like you're moving backwards and is feeling like it's preventing you from finding blessings in your life or from inviting, because I bet a lot of you are feeling like you're not getting anything. But remember, whatever you resist persists, and it will persist this way as long as you resist this. Okay? All right, Pisces, I'm gonna leave you with that. I wish you nothing but the best. I really, really do. August is tough for everyone, so don't stress. Hopefully in September we'll have this new like zest. I'm really hoping September is gonna be like a breath of fresh air, because it's been too long for all of us to have this difficult, you know, potent attachment of this like thing that just won't release itself from your back kind of thing. So anyway, that is all. I wish you good luck. All right, thanks. Bye.